high notes can be one of the most exhilarating but also terrifying experiences for singers. There's all kinds of things that can go wrong. You know, you can have a flip or a crack, or you could miss your note, or you could have this sudden loss of power. And those are not things you want to be thinking about when you're approaching that big moment in your song. So in this lesson, we're going to talk about some things that you can do that will help you to have success on the high notes. Let's dive in. Now, before we begin, I just want to mention that singing high notes is kind of like the heavy lifting of singing. So you want to make sure that you're warming up, you're in good vocal health, and that you have a regular practice routine before you try these exercises. So the first thing we want to do is find the notes. And we don't want to do this with all of our force and power out the gates. We want to warm up to it. You only have so much vocal energy in a day. And if you use all of that by just jumping in and trying to sing that huge note before you've warmed up, before you've found the notes, you're gonna fatigue very, very quickly. So I'm gonna close my mouth and make a really, really creaky sound like this. Barely touching the notes. One more time. It's not meant to sound pretty, it's just meant to help you establish comfort, like, oh, I know where those notes are, I got this. Once you're comfortable there, I'm gonna suggest, if you can, grab a straw. This is my singing straw. You can use just a regular narrow, if you can find one of those little small drinking straws, you can do that. So with my straw, it's gonna sound like this. So it's good, it's surprising how much energy, and you'll notice like your core starts to engage as you work with this. And this is really good. This is gonna set you up for success, and it's a very safe way to practice finding and singing those notes. So let's do it again. And I'm allowing myself to hold that last one a little bit longer, just sort of settling in, continuing the process of warming up. Now, if you don't have a straw, you can just puff up your cheeks and sing it like this. So I'm holding that last note, I'm making sure that my cheeks stay inflated, and it feels like a lot of work that way as well. So both of these approaches are gonna be super beneficial. They're really, really gonna help you develop strength in your voice and prepare for singing those high notes. Now, once you're comfortable doing that, we're going to try singing that line and removing the straw as we go. This is gonna blow your minds. It's probably my favorite vocal trick ever. So the word that Celine is singing is anymore. I want you to focus on m or mo, because we're not gonna worry about the rest of the word right now. So as you're singing with the straw, I want you to think, oh, so I'm gonna go like this. Boom, there's the note. It's so surprising to me every time I do that, because you've got the straw and there's all this resistance. You take the straw away and it's like, whoa, was that me? That felt so balanced and free. So I'm gonna do that one more time. There it is. And it's like, when you do that, you're gonna feel surprised. You're gonna be like, was that me? That felt too easy. So we're not stylizing it yet. We're not adding all the drama or singing it like Celine, but we're teaching our body how it feels when we sing a high note with balance and freedom. So that's a really, really great trick to practice any note that's giving you trouble. Next, I wanna talk about the magic of So as singers, when we go for high notes, our larynx can sometimes creep up, up, up. And so our larynx is where our vocal cords live. And as we tense and this larynx comes up, our body's like, oh, we're gonna swallow, because that's what it's designed to do. But then everything kind of tightens and it becomes very difficult to sing. So we want to kind of balance that out by bringing our larynx into a more neutral position. And one way we can do that is by thinking about the vowel uh. So if you place your hand on your throat and just go if you think like, Patrick from SpongeBob, he's got like a voice like this. You're gonna do that and you're gonna feel your larynx come down. So when you're going for a high note, you can sort of steal the magic of this and it's going to help just make more space and more freedom for that sound. So I'm gonna do the same trick with the straw. I'm gonna sing and I'm gonna release into this time, and I'm gonna think about kind of bringing that larynx down just slightly and noticing how that feels, if it feels a little bit more free. Watch. So there was again, and that one felt even better. So I was just adding a little bit of underneath my big note, and suddenly things felt a lot smoother. So that little bit of that neutralizing of the position of the larynx really frees things up. And then you're like, oh, okay, I'm good, and I can continue singing wherever the song is going to take me. Where's your tongue? A lot of times when we're singing, especially these big notes, our tongue can kind of pull up and back, especially on a word like more, where our tongue kind of lifts. So I want you to think about keeping your tongue down, relaxed, and forward. And if you've ever watched, the best example I found of this is Adam Lambert. When he sings those crazy high notes, his tongue's like hanging out of his face. So you don't have to be that extreme, but just be mindful. Also, think about your jaw. You wanna stay as relaxed as you can through here. If you're tense and tight, it's gonna just make things more difficult. So now that we've found the notes, we've used our straw, we've talked about our larynx, and we've warmed ourselves up to this high note, it's time to really go for it. But this is the tricky part, is you have to approach that note with the energy it deserves and requires. So if you're like trying to sing your high note and you're kind of like this and you're not really committing to it, it's gonna be underwhelming. So you need to bring your energy in. So don't be afraid to like move your body, lean into a little bit, open up into a bit of like a power stance as you go for that note. It's gonna actually help. So here's what I mean. Now, all of those steps take time, they take practice, they take getting used to. So I'm showing them to you in sequence here so you can begin to experiment with these ideas, but ideally, you're going to get into a vocal routine or workout that helps you to target and focus on these things if singing high notes is your goal. So we've got all of that covered for you in the Singeo method. We customize a whole routine just for your specific unique voice type, and we'll walk you through all the steps you need to achieve that balance so that you can sing these big high notes with all of the ease and freedom you could possibly imagine. So I hope that these tips have been helpful. I would love to hear from you about what your favorite like big moment in a song is. I know that for me, I always listened to Mariah Carey and Celine Dion when I was growing up, and I heard them sing these crazy notes, so I was like, oh, I want to do that. So I want to hear from you. What are the singers, or what are the songs, what are the notes that inspire you to sing? Comment below, and I will see you around.